Welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. I am Ayush Jain and today I am giving you a demo of transistor characteristics. The order code of this equipment is 36153. Now this is our equipment. In this we have four displays in which first is DC voltmeter 2 volt by 20 volt, DC ammeter 200 microampere by 20 milliampere, DC ammeter 200 microampere by 20 milliampere, and DC voltmeter 2 volt by 20 volt. These are the toggle switches. We can keep it to 2 volt or to 20 volt. Similarly, this to 200 microampere or 20 milliampere. This is the variable voltage knob, which we can vary 0 to 10 volt at 50 milliampere. Similarly, this is 0 to 10 volt DC at 50 milliampere variable knob. These are the four transistors. These two are the silicon transistors, PNP and NPN, and these two are the germanium transistors, PNP or NPN. This is the main power on-off switch to on the kit. Now let me take you to the experiment. Our first experiment is common emitter configuration. In this, I will show you all the common emitter configuration for silicon transistor. The same can be performed on germanium transistor with same connections. Just you have to replace that transistor from silicon to germanium. Now first common emitter silicon transistor, which is NPN silicon transistor. Now the connections are connect this positive to this point. This negative to this point, connect this positive to this point, this negative to emitter, move this negative to the base of emitter, connect the collected to this negative, connect this emitter to the negative of this voltage, connect this positive to this positive, and connect this again this positive to this point and negative to this point. Before starting the kit, first of all, set this variable knobs to completely anti-clockwise for the zero value. Now switch on the main power supply. These are the various displays. You can see zero initially. Now set the collector voltage to 1 volt. Set the collector voltage to 1 volt. Now this is our collector voltage knob. Set it to 1 volt. This is collector voltage. As you have to set it to 1 volt only to keep the toggle switch at 2 volt knob. Now I have setted my collector voltage to 1 volt. This is my collector voltage 1 volt. Now as I vary my base voltage, vary the base voltage in volts and measure the base current IV in microampere. Now vary the base voltage and measure the IV current in microampere. As you have to measure the IV current in microampere, set this switch to microampere. Now vary the base voltage. Vary it slowly. Now you can see the base current as the drop 0.7 volt occur. Take the different readings and note the values with the variation of 0.1 volt. This is the working of NPN silicon transistor. Now you will obtain the various readings. Initially I have set my VC at 1 volt. Now I will set my VC at 5 volt and take another reading for 5 volt. For 5 volt supply, change this switch to 20 volt. Now my VC is approximately 5 volt. Now vary the base voltage. Now as you can see, vary the base voltage. It will be nearly zero till the 0.7 drop, as we know that the 0.7 is the breakdown voltage. 0.7 is the breakdown. After 0.7, the current will suddenly rise and you can take various readings till it crosses the value. These are the two tables that we have to make. First, VC at 1 volt, vary the VB and measure IB. Second, VC at 5 volt, vary VB and measure IB. These are the two graphs, these are the graphs that you will obtain at VC and VC equal to 1 volt and at VC equal to 5 volt. Now I will do for silicon PNP. I have done for silicon NPN, same you can done for germanium NPN. Same connection, just you have to use germanium transistor instead of silicon transistor. Rest connections are same. Now I am showing you for silicon PNP transistor. Let me get ready for the connections. Now the connections of silicon transistor PNP. Now these are my connections. First of all, connect this positive to positive, this negative to negative, connect this positive to this E point, connect this negative to negative, connect this positive to the base of PNP transistor, connect this emitter to this positive, connect this collector to positive, connect this positive to this positive, this negative over here, and again this negative over this point. First of all, set this knob to fully anti-clockwise for zero value. Now switch on the supply. first of all, we have to set the base current to 25 microampere. So before setting the base current, set this toggle switch to 200 microampere position. Position this collector switch to 20 milliampere position and this base voltage switch to 20 voltage position. Now as I increase, move it clockwise, vary it very slowly as the changes occur suddenly. This is approximately 25 microampere my IB. Now I will vary my collector voltage and measure the collector current in milliampere. Take different readings accordingly. Now as I vary my collector voltage, my collector current will vary. Take different readings at different voltages. At a step of say 1 volt, 1 volt, 2 volt, 3 volt and 4 volt and 5 volt, take different value of collector current in milliampere. This is the working of PNP silicon transistor. We can keep different values of IB initially constant. As I have kept 25 microampere, you can keep 30 microampere and 35 microampere and change the collector voltage and calculate the collector current. Now the second experiment is common base configuration. In this, first the NPN silicon transistor for common base. These are my connections. Connect this positive to this positive. Negative to negative. Connect this positive to base. Negative to this point. This positive to emitter. Collector, this negative. Base to this negative. This positive to this positive. This positive to this positive of voltmeter and this negative to this negative of voltmeter. Now as we switch on our main supply, first we have to set the collector voltage to 1 volt. So keep this toggle switch to 2 volt, as we have to set it to 1 volt only. Keep the collector voltage to 1 volt. Vary this knob and keep the collector voltage to 1 volt. This is approximately 1 volt. Now set the emitter current IE to 200 microampere. Set this switch to 200 microampere. Now vary the emitter voltage and measure the IE current, emitter current in microampere. As you can see, the current is varying. Vary the voltage through this knob and vary the desired current. Take different readings accordingly. Now keep the, this was the working of the NPN silicon transistor. we can use the NPN germanium transistor. The connections are same, just we have to replace this transistor through this transistor. That's it. Now we will do the silicon PNP transistor. The transistor characteristics of silicon PNP transistor. First, let me get ready for the connections. Now, the connections for silicon PNP transistor. These are the connections. First, connect this positive to this positive. Connect this negative to this negative. Connect this positive to this point. Connect this emitter to this negative. Connect this negative to base. Connect this base to this negative. Connect this collector to this positive point. Negative to this positive. Connect this positive to this point. And this negative to this point. Make both the knobs completely anti-clockwise before switching on the kit. Now, switch on the kit by varying this voltage. Set the emitter current to nearly 2 milliampere. For setting it to 2 milliampere, keep this toggle switch to 20 milliampere. Slowly vary it as the variation is occurred suddenly. Now this is my approximately 2 milliampere. Now vary the collector voltage accordingly and measure the IC current in microampere. For measuring the IC current in microampere, keep this toggle switch to microampere, 200 microampere. Now vary the, as it is showing out of range initially. Now vary the collector voltage. For varying the collector voltage, set it to 20 volt. As you have to take different readings. Now vary the collector voltage accordingly. Initially it is in negative, as you can see. We have inverted this polarity in order to see the negative current. As you can see in this graph, initially the current starts from negative. In the PNP, initially the current starts from negative, as you can see. So for that we have reversed the polarity. Now again reverse, we have again received reverse the polarity to check the current. as it is going beyond the range of 200 microampere, set it to 20 milliampere over here. As you can see, when it is into 200 microampere, it is going beyond the range of 200 microampere. So we convert, set it to 20 milliampere. Now vary the collector voltage over here and see the collector current at different levels. That's it for the PNP silicon transistor. The same you can perform for germanium transistor by just replacing the transistor from silicon to germanium. Rest all the connections are same. Now we move on to common collector. Now common collector configuration, the third object. In this I am using NPN silicon transistor to show the input characteristics of common collector. Now in this, first let me make the connections. Positive of this connected to positive of this. Connected to negative. Now positive of this point is connected in series with the DTM of this, and this negative is connected to the base of NPN and negative of this voltage supply is connected to the collector and negative of this supply is connected to the collector. Negative of this is also connected to this, and this positive is connected to this positive. Now this positive is connected to the negative of this DPM, and this positive is connected to the emitter. Now these are the connections for common collector NPN silicon transistor. For input characteristics, what we have to do before switching on the system, first make sure that both the knobs are completely anti-clockwise, that is zero position. Now as we switch on the device, first of all keep this knob to 20 volt and set VCE to approximately 3 volt. This is VCE approximately 3 volt. Now we will vary VCB and measure the IB current in microampere. For IB current in microampere, turn this switch to microampere. Turn this to microampere. Now we will vary VCB and we will see the variation in IB. As you can see, as the voltage increases, the current increases, and after a certain value it goes beyond the range. As you can see in this graph, as the voltage increases, current increases and then goes beyond the range. In this, beyond the range, it starts with this and then at a certain value the current becomes zero. Now to show the output characteristics of this, I will use the NPN silicon transistor only. You can use NPN germanium transistor also, just have to replace the transistor and the connections are all same. Now to show the output characteristics, what we have to do, first of all set IB, which is this IB current, set it to approximately 100 microampere. By varying this, set it to approximately 100 microampere. as I have set it to around, this is approximately 100 microampere. Now we will vary VCE and measure IE. To measure IE, keep this knob at 20 milliampere. Keep this knob to 20 milliampere and vary VCE through this knob, vary VCE and measure IE. As I vary VCE, the IE currents varies. As you can see. And after a certain point, it becomes constant. This is the function of the output characteristics of the NPN silicon transistor. As you can see, the output characteristics vary like this. Now, we can also use PNP transistor to show the input and output characteristics. The connection and the circuits are clearly given in the manual. You can consult. You just have to vary the transistor and the connections you can see exactly, which are similar to NPN, a slight variation, which is exactly given in the manual, and you can make them and get the input and output characteristics, which are similar to the NPN type. Now the last object is transfer characteristics to show the relationship between input and output voltages. Now for this, first let me make the connections. Now the connections for transfer characteristics. Now connect this positive terminal to this positive, this negative terminal to this negative, connect this negative to this negative, connect this positive to the emitter of NPN silicon transistor. I am using NPN silicon transistor. Connect this negative to the base of NPN silicon transistor. Connect the collector to the positive of this. Connect this negative to this negative. And this positive of voltage, variable voltage, to this DPM positive. We can make the same connections for silicon NPM or germanium NPM. Now we will keep, as we switch on the main power supply, make sure that the both the knobs are fully anti-clockwise. Now as we switch on, set collector voltage VC to approximately 1 voltage. First you can take this knob to 2 volt, as you have to set it to 1 volt only. Now this is my approximately 1 volt. Approximately 1 volt VC. Now we will again make some changes in the connections. For that, For that, what we have to do now, in order to measure the transfer characteristics, after making this connection, as we have set this 1 volt, as we have already set this 1 volt, now make some changes, as remove this voltmeter from the collector point and put it on the base terminal. Now we will vary VB and we will measure this voltage as VL. As you can see in the table, we have kept VC as 1 volt fixed. We will vary VB from this knob and we will calculate VL from this point, VL. Now I will vary VB, as you can see, and my voltage is increasing. As it goes beyond 2, take this knob to 20 volt and put this knob also to 20 volt. Now vary the voltage and record readings for VB and VL. You will get the graph as given in our manual according to this. Now transfer characteristics for PNP silicon or germanium. First, let me get ready for the connections. Now the transfer characteristics for the PNP. I'm using silicon transistor, we can use germanium also. Connect this positive to this positive, this negative to emitter. Connect this positive to this positive, this negative to this negative. Connect this positive to the base. Connect this collector to the negative terminal. Now connect this positive to this positive and this negative to this negative. After making the connection, make sure that both these knobs are completely anti-clockwise. We have to do the same thing what we have done in the NPN transistor. First of all, set VC to approximately 1 volt. As I have set VC to approximately 1 volt. Now remove this voltmeter, this voltage supply from collector. Remove this voltage supply from collector and make this connection to for base. Now this is knob will vary VB. As you can see in this, this knob will vary VB and you can measure VL on this screen. As I vary VB, my VL will also get vary. My VL will also vary. Take the appropriate readings, 5 to 10 readings at one step voltage, and draw the graph between VB and VL. The graph will be like this, as given in our table for PNP transistor silicon. The slope will be further reduced as compared to NPN transistor. This is the working of PNP silicon transistor for transfer characteristics. These are the experiments for the transistor characteristics kit. For any further information, please consult the lab manual. Thank you.